What's up, you guys? Shardimus Prime here, doing another Star Wars 6-inch Black Series action figure review on the Rogue One A Star Wars Story Toys R Us exclusive Imperial Hover Tank Pilot. If you're trying to get your Star Wars figures, you can get them at
big. Get your big badass toys at BigBadToyStore.com. Click the link in the description below.
But if you wanted to get this specific figure right here, you can only get it at Toys R Us because it's got a Toys R Us sticker right over there, and it's a Toys R Us exclusive. Anyway, very cool looking piece. I believe there's a Walgreens exclusive also that my friend Chew found for me, so thank you so much, Chew. I'm looking forward to that one. On the side, you can see it says Imperial Hover Tank Pilot. On the very back, you can see a read-up on the figure. If you want to read it, go ahead and pause it now. And on the side, not much more going on except for saying Imperial Hover Tank Pilot. All right, let's get to it and crack this thing open. And here's the Hover Tank Pilot out of the packaging, looking sick. I really like this piece a lot. What really makes me like it more than anything else are the paint apps. I really like that we get this brown wash and we get some gray wash over the white, making it look very weathered and very cool to me. I also really like the design of the Hover Tank Pilot. It reminds me of the Stormtrooper, of course, but definitely something fresh and new here with some of the designs, so I really dig that a lot. He only comes with one accessory, which is his blaster, so we'll take a closer look at that, and then we'll take a closer look at the Hover Tank Pilot. Now, if I remember correctly, I don't think we actually ever see the Hover Tank Pilot use this. I just remember seeing him riding the Hover Tank and then getting blown to tiny bits, but I need to watch the movie again. I cannot wait to see the movie once more. Now, I thought this was the same exact sculpt as your regular Stormtrooper blaster, but it's not. Of course, the Stormtrooper blaster has a little number right there. This one does not have that, so I guess they're slightly different molds, but they do look very similar. The biggest difference for me I'm seeing right here is the color. We get a lighter color gray right here. This is just a jet black, and we get some tiny little sparklies in the plastic, which I always appreciate, so that's pretty sweet. He does not have any blaster storage on him whatsoever. That's a little bit frustrating. Now, I really have to dim my settings here so that we can capture all the details in the camera, but man, there's a lot of paint on this, and I was very stoked to see this on the shelf at Toys R Us. I saw a bunch of them, and I went through a bunch just to make sure I got the one with the paint apps that I liked, so I recommend you do that, but I went back a week later, and they were all gone, so yeah, I feel like I'm very lucky to have this figure. I mean, look at all that paint. It looks so good. Oh man, I'm really liking all the little gashes of dirt and everything right over there. On the top of the helmet looks really good. I think I really like this design too because it kind of reminds me of a clone trooper as well. Get that marking right over there at the very top. A lot of paint on this guy. I just think it looks really neat. And a little pack right over there on the back looks really nice. Looks really good. We got some silver bits. I mean, really, man. I'm very happy with this. Now I have to brighten things up so that you can see that we get this ribbed pattern underneath the armor right there. So his, what would you call it, his exosuit or whatever, like the, you know, the undersuit right there. He has some nice lines on around that turtleneck right over there as well. You can see the color kind of changes right there in the center. These are flexible enough where they don't really hinder the articulation. And you do have a little inconsistency with the color, right? Like his pants are this dark green, then the rest of it is black. I don't know if we see him from the waist down at all in the movie. Again, you just see him from the waist up hanging out of the tank. Unless there's another scene that I can't remember off the top of my head. But I just remember seeing him from the waist up riding the tank. But I do like how these pants look. We get this nice pattern sculpted in there. It looks very good. The boots look really good too. I'm really liking that. Again, paint wash just consistent throughout on this figure. Just makes me very happy. I love the paint details, man. What can I say? And there's a Hover Tank Pilot butt and a little trooper canister right there. The articulation isn't so bad on this figure either. He can look up a little bit, so that's pretty good. And he can look down very far, so he gets a lot more movement moving downward. There is a disc hinge in there. Not much head pivot really, but you do get some solid side-to-side movement. The shoulders move outward very far, and I love what they've done here is that they've made these shoulder pads go into the torso, so there's no conflict or there's no rub or anything like that. Oh, maybe there might be. You can see a little bit of lightness of paint right over there, but not on this side, so I'm pretty happy with that. The arms also move forward very well, and they move downward too, so you can get his arms close to his body if you wanted to put him in some kind of tank accessory that might be coming out in the future. Ooh, I don't know. I haven't heard any word of that, though. Maybe you have. But anyway, bending the elbows, you can see it meets at 90 degrees. You get rotation at the elbow. The wrist moves side to side. Then they hinge side to side right here on the right hand, like a roll of the dice movement. But on the left side, it hinges up and down. You get a diaphragm joint that turns turn side to side. You do get some good diaphragm pivot, and he crunches forward very well and back. I wish his hip joints were a little bit better. They only move outward that much. He can kick forward pretty far, though. I like that. Wow. And back just a little bit. Upper thigh cut. Double jointed knees. And then his ankles move down, up, and he does have ankle pivot. Time to measure out this hover tank pilot. You can see that he's standing just a little over 6 inches tall. Then for your trooper comparison, we have the hover tank pilot compared to the scout trooper, stormtrooper, and the clone trooper. And I'm also picking up the two new Black Series waves that are coming out. So yeah, a lot more Black Series figure reviews for you guys coming soon. But I won't be reviewing any of those figures until after I review the Marvel Legends Sandman wave. But anyway, comparing this hover tank trooper to all of my other Rogue One figures, we have Jyn Erso, Captain Cassian, we have a Death Trooper, and we have K2SO. Then here's the hover tank trooper next to the Marvel Legends Big Time No Letdown Spider-Man. So correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe the Scarif Trooper shares the same body mold as this figure right over here, and I'm very excited to get that one. That one has more paint on it, but this one right here I think looks very good. I'm very happy with it, and I'm glad to have it in my collection. And I hope you guys are happy with this review. If you are, please hit the like button, hit the notification bell so that you know when more Shardimus Prime videos are coming your way. If you are not subscribed, please go ahead and hit the subscribe circle that will be popping up right over there. If you want to see a photo gallery of images, it should all be up at JediInsider.com, and I have action figures for sale over at ShardimusPrime.net. I'll catch you guys later. Peace. Opposing action figures, opposing action figures, opposing action figures every day. Opposing action figures, opposing action figures, opposing action figures, it's okay.
That's crispy.
Derp. Derp. Derp.